Hi, Kerry here from My Quick Bookkeeping. Today we're going to have a look at one of the recent improvements to QuickBooks Online, and that's the ability to do progress invoicing. The ability to do progress invoicing provides better transparency to your clients and customers. It can help you to improve your cash flow. And I know it's one of the reasons some people haven't changed from QuickBooks Desktop to QuickBooks Online. So let's have a look today at how that works.
So here we are in the US sample company. In order to do progress invoicing, we need to turn on that option. So we'll pop up here to the gear icon and go to Accounts and Settings. Under Sales, we scroll down. Here we are, Progress Invoicing. So we're going to edit this so that now we can create multiple partial invoices from a single estimate. And we'll save it. So we're done in this area. And we'll go to Sales. And we're going to prepare an estimate for our customer. So let's go here and select Estimate. It's a little slow today. And we'll select a customer. Let's go with Dylan. And for Dylan, we're going to sell him some gardening. No, we don't want the weekly gardening service. Let's go for a big job. Here, an installation. And we're going to send him an estimate of, say, 250 hours at $50 an hour, and perhaps we'll also add some lighting, and that can be one piece at, we'll say, $2,500. And the lighting has tax on it. This is probably something that we've set up earlier. So now we will save and send our estimate to Dylan. Okay, we're going to save and close it because we're not really sending it anyway. It's a sample company. So now let's say that we've gone off and we've done a whole pile of work for Dylan. And we've been working on this job for a while. We need to pay our guys. We need to pay for the lighting. We've got to keep the lights on in our office too. So we're going to grab this estimate here from Dylan. And we're going to choose this option here to create an invoice. So how much do you want to invoice? Let's do a custom amount for each line. So we're going to create our invoice from the estimate. And we're going to say that we're going to invoice him. And we're going to invoice for half of this. So this will be, we're going to go for a percentage, 50% of this $12,500. And then the garden lighting, we want to bill all of this. Let's say that we've installed all the lighting and we want to bill him for all of that. And we'll be finishing off the rest of the landscaping later. So we're going to save and close this report, or this invoice. Really, we'll save and send it, but we're not sending it to Dylan, so we can't. So now let's have return and have a look at this estimate and just see what's remaining on it. We can see here that we had an original estimate for $15,000. We sent out the invoice for $8,750, and the remaining subtotal is $6,250. So this is much easier for the client. They can pay as it goes. It's much better for you to have money as you go, and it pays it down from that estimate. And it's so great that with this feature is now included in our QuickBooks.
If you have any questions or would like to know how this could work for your business, please do reach out. All the links are below. While you're down there, click like, subscribe to my channel. There's a month-end checklist that you can download there as well, which will help you to keep your books in order at the end of every month. And if there's anything else you'd like to know, please do let me know. Write a comment below. My next video could be for you. Cheers.